Analysis, welcome all. And I'm Manideep. I'm going to represent the Defour Analytics. We are into training and business and providing the solutions to the company. So today we are going to discuss about the sentiment analysis. So today's agenda is about, we'll be discussing what is sentiment analysis and where it is going to be applied. What are the questions the sentiment analysis might ask and what are the challenges that we are going to face in that and how it is done. So first of all, by hearing the word sentiment analysis, what is the term you will be getting? That is sentiment, that is belief, that people will be having beliefs towards something. Like if you took a product, we will be believing that the product is good or not by keeping some of the sentimental beliefs on that. So like that way, we are going to analyze the product by doing the sentiment analysis. So let's go further. So what is meant by sentiment analysis? First of all, sentiment equal to feelings, that is attitudes or emotions or opinions. That means each and every user will be having the different opinion on the particular product. It may be differing from one another. So that is, each and every product will be having the subjective impressions, but not the facts. Over here, what it states, subjective impressions differing from one person to other. Like you may like the product, but the other person don't like the product. So it matters a lot over here in the sentimental analysis. So like next, what is sentimental analysis? It is also called as an option mining and the emotion AI. So what is option mining first of all? The word itself indicates that it means a collection of data from the users about the product for tracking the mood of the public. And next, emotional artificial intelligence. It means it is totally user-based perspective that it is going to detect the human emotions. So next, it is going to use the natural language processing. So we are the humans. We are going to communicate by using some of the language like Hindi, English or Telugu or whichever that may be. But in order to communicate to any personal machine or anything, we should use the natural language processing. So what does natural language processing mean? Actually, it is the area of computer science where AI is, where the interaction between the computer and the humans gonna takes place. So next, the text analysis. So what does the text analysis mean? We are gonna analyze the text to get the readable facts so that we will be deriving some of the conclusion. And next, computational linguistics. Over here, linguistics means it's a language. And what does the computational linguistics means? So over here, it states that we'll be analyzing the language and bringing some of the conclusion over here. Next, the biometrics. It is a technique where we will be measuring the body measurements of the human beings. So it is mostly related to the human characteristics. So this is what in sentimental analysis we are going to be doing. And we will be identifying the data and extracting the data. And we will be using some of the subjective information in the sentimental analysis. So next, where the sentimental analysis will be applied more. So it is going to apply in the reviews. So by seeing that itself, you can know, first of all, by hearing the term reviews, what is the most prominent thing that is going to come to your mind? That is, if you're going to buy anything from Amazon, so you're not aware of that product. So what you will be doing, first of all, you will be checking the reviews. If the reviews are positive, you will be going to the product. If the reviews are not positive, you'll be definitely ignoring the product. So over here, the reviews plays a dominant role in the sentiment analysis. And next, the survey responses. So you'll be thinking how the survey responses will be related to the sentiment analysis. If you want to start any business and you're new to place, so you just want to do one survey whether the business will be clicking over here or not. So for example, you just wanted to start any dry food business in one place. So you won't be knowing how the people over here will be living, what are their way of behavior, you don't know anything. So we will be doing the further survey first of all. After doing the survey, if you're going to get any positive insights from that, then you're going to start the business over there. So like that, we are going to do the sentimental, apply the sentimental analysis over here. And the online and social media, in the online and social media. So first of all, in the online and social media, the social media will be dividing upon the male and the female category. So whatever the product, they will be taken from the company. So that is analyzed in the online by the company. In the online and social media, such as Facebook and Instagram and Twitter, whatever it may be. So they will be taking the review of each and every person so that it is beneficial for the company for the for launching the product and go further. So, and next, the healthcare materials. So how the healthcare materials will be coming in the sentiment analysis? Like nowadays, because of the increase in the technology, everyone is getting so many diseases and everything. But in order to find out the disease, it is taking too much of time rather than curing that. So in the sentiment analysis, first of all, we will be taking all the users' data, like how the Google is doing now. Like Google has started some, it's Google AI. So over there, it is going to capture all the users' data. And after that, it is going to analyze the data by using some of the machine learning algorithms. So after that, it is going to send the data to the respective doctors. So before the disease is occurring, the doctor will be prescribing to the patient that you have been occurring some this disease, so you can go further by doing this other activity. So in this case, it is going to useful for the doctor and as well as the patient also. So like this, the sentimental analysis will be applied over here. So next, you'll be thinking, what will be the questions like sentimental analysis will be asking? So mostly if any product has a too much of demand, so what will be the competitor will be doing? He just wanted to degrade the competitor demand of the product. So at that time, he will be giving the first negative reviews for the competitor, so that he will be getting beneficial. So this is a one type of question that we will be sentiment analysis will be asking, and whether the customer has been satisfied or dissatisfied with the product. Like if you purchase any product and the company want to know whether the consumer has been satisfied or not. So after purchasing of the product, the company will be asking the consumer to register their product in the company. And after that, they will be submitting a survey. Like, did you like the product? What are its faults and what are its benefits? Whether you like the product. So it is going to ask the customer, and if any problems will be there, then the company will be solving that. So this is also one type of question that sentiment analysis will be asking. And third question is like, based on the sample tweets, like all the celebrities and everyone will be there. So they will be tweeting all the campaigns and everything. So we will be selecting the data and making sure that the data is relevant or not, whether we will be getting any positive insights from the data. So we will be knowing by doing the sentiment analysis. We'll be knowing further after going in each and every slide. So what we get from essay. So in the essay, first of all, we will be getting all the information by doing the sentiment analysis. And also we can also give the questionnaire to the consumers based upon the sentiments and everything. And also we can summarize each and every point by doing the sentiment analysis. And what are the challenges that the sentiment analysis will be facing? So mostly the first challenge is about whether to know whether the text is misleading or not. Like if any product is there, the competitor will be doing that in order to degrade the sales of the product. He will be giving that negative review, whatever the product it may be. So we should identify that one, whether the review is positive or negative, who has given that. So this is also one type of challenge that sentiment analysis will be facing. And also intertextual and substantial reversals. That means some of the words will be having the positive and the negative effect also.
Shh. share the Zoom key.
Shall I continue or shall I continue from starting? Sorry for the inconvenience, actually there is a problem over here. So what are the challenges that we'll be facing in a sentiment analysis? First of all, we will be knowing the text, whether it is genuine or not, whether it is misleading or we can rely on the text. So this is the first type of challenge that we will be facing in the sentiment analysis. And the second point is about knowing the text, whether it is relevant or not. First of all, like too much of data that the users will be given, but we should know whether the data is positive or negative, because each and every data has too many meanings. So this is also one type of challenge that we will be facing in the sentiment analysis. So third point is about sarcasm, irony, and implication. Like we can see the example over here, that Roshan Agarwal has posted that thank you for sending my baggage to Hyderabad and flying me to Calcutta at the same time. Brilliant service. Over here, the brilliant service is a sarcasm post. So, and for that, the Indigo has replied, glad to hear that. So over here, Indigo has failed doing the sentiment analysis. So this is one of the challenges that we'll be facing in the sentiment analysis. So first of all, how the sentiment analysis will be done? So over here, first of all, what is the intertextual and substantial reversals and negotiation topic common, change common? Over here, it means that each and every point, like how the data will be collecting, each and every data will be having the different meaning. So we should analyze the data and we will be getting the positive meaning for that. If it is a positive, we should analyze that. We should know whether the data is positive or negative. So that is about that point.
For example, that there is a sarcasm there.
It is about the third point. Okay. So first of all, we should analyze the point. These are the challenges that we will be facing in the sentiment analysis. Next, how the essay is done. So we can do the sentiment analysis according to the user, or text, or sentences, or predetermined descriptive phrases, and words and tweets. So first of all, users. So we'll be collecting too much of data. So collecting the large data and doing some of the analysis, it takes too much of time. So rather than that, we can classify according to the users. Like there are 100 people. So we'll be classifying the data into male and female according to the category, so that it will be relevant for easy calculation analysis of the data. So, and the text also. So we will be selecting some of the text from the data which is relevant, and we'll be doing the sentiment analysis. And the sentences, like of chunks of text, we'll be selecting some of the text which are important. Like for example, if you take any product, Amazon, there are too many products. You are taking the mobile. The reviews over there, you can see battery, camera, good, and all the main works will be there. So that are the paragraphs or chunks over here. So we will be analyzing the data and we'll be getting the important terms from that. And the tweets and updates. So we'll be analyzing the tweets and we'll be doing the sentiment analysis so that we can go further. So next, what are the techniques that there in sentiment analysis? There are mostly three types of techniques in the sentiment analysis. So first technique is about the semantic orientation and polarity of words. And the second is about text-based classification. And third is incorporating the shallow linguistics. So let's go further to know about the techniques. So first of all, semantic orientation and polarity of words. So over here, we will be measuring the each and every text. And it has a binary value, that is 0 or 1. And we'll be saying whether the text is positive or negative. For example, you just booked a movie. So after booking the movie, you will be checking the reviews. So over there, after reading that, we should know whether the review is positive or negative. So over here, it is going to do that. In the semantic orientation and polarity of words, it is going to extract the data from the user document, and it is going to analyze by using some of the formula. So over here, polarity is determined. So next, text-based classification. So in the text-based classification, it has been segregated into these types by topic and by sentiment and by language, by gender and by the author. Like what is by topic means? For example, if you take any books, ebooks. So over here, if you want a specific ebook, we don't know how what the user is known about. So we will be segregating according to the user specification, like how he has previously ordered. So we will be using the data and we'll be doing the sentimental analysis on that. And by the language also. By gender. Over here it states that each and every user has different perspective. Like some users will be liking the fiction books. Some users will be liking comedy books. Some will be liking some other. So we will be dividing according to the gender of the author also and the language. So these are the some of the classification that we can do in the sentimental analysis. It's not about we should follow this only. We can create our own classification. It depends upon our. So there are firstly three steps in the sentimental analysis. The first step is called as the initiation step. So over here, what happens? We will be collecting huge number of data. After that, we will be processing the data by removing all the irrelevant items. And after that, we will be selecting the words from the second step. From the processing of data, we'll be coming to the attribute selection. It means a bag of words. We'll be keeping each and every important words over there. So this total will be covered in the first step. And the second step is a learning step. If you want to do any project, first of all, you will be in two parts. Because the data is huge, we can't use the data at a time. So we will be first of all testing some amount of data. And after that, we'll be training that. So we will be testing some part of data by using some of the algorithm. So that is going to cover in this learning step. And the third step is about the evaluation step. So after testing, if it is successful, they will be doing the whole amount of data over here. So this is the mainly three steps that we're going to cover in the sentimental analysis. And this is the third method, incorporating the shallow linguistics. Actually, this is a pipeline of the different languages. It consists of two services, first of all. First one is the language identification. And second one is the analyze the language. We should identify the language and analyze that. So what does the language identification mean? For example, if you take any Amazon, it is in India, Canada, France, and too many countries. So the users will be giving depending upon their language. So first of all, we should categorize according to the country. We should identify the language of the data of the user. So over here we have done into English, Canada, and whatever the language it may be. And there are some of the steps will be there in the language identification. First of all, we are going to split the sentences. Whatever the user has given the data, we are going to split the sentences. After that, we'll be doing the tokenization. And next process is called as nematization after that. And next POS and the NERC. After doing all this, we'll be getting the conversion rate of that product. So we'll be discussing this further. What is all about? What is tokenization and what is lemmatization?
Are there different packages for different languages?
It will be. Okay. We'll be installing in the R and everything.
If you have any question, then you can
ask. You can ask in the decision. So now you can get how it has been divided according to the language. So in the language analysis, first of all, we are going to split the sentences according to the user. And next, the tokenization. So what does tokenization actually mean? So each and every company will be analyzing the data and giving to some of the companies to get some meaningful insights. The company will be giving the data to some other company. There will be some of the privacy issues. So the company will be replacing the data with some other dummy digits. So that is the method is called as a tokenization. And next is called as lemmatization. So what does lemmatization mean? Like if you get some of the reviews from the customer, it will be discussing further about the lemmatization and the named entity classification. So next, lemmatization. Like we can see over here, it means mapping from text word to lemma. Help verb. We have taken the word help over here. So we will be considering the help, helps, helping, and help. These all terms are only one word in the sentiment analysis, so that we can do, we can process the data easily. So over here, all these words will be only one word, that is help. This is the lemmatization. And what is tokenization? As I said to you, that company will be having the privacy issues, so they will be giving some of the dummy digits. So for example, any review that the company has taken from the data, in that reviews, these are the common things that are available over here. For example, common is there over here. The common is replaced with the digit C, number alphabet C, and the proper has been replaced with the alphabet P. So like that, we will be replacing with each and every alphabet, and we will be going further in the tokenization process. This is totally about ensuring the privacy issues in the company.
Like Google and Uber, they don't want to share their data.
Yes. And the named entity recognition. After this is the name itself indicates that if any review we got from the particular product, so we should recognize whether what is that is about, what is the review is about. For example, we can see over here, this is one type of the sentence. So over here, it has recognized the particular names over here, like Andrew Wickley, he's a person, and the labor, and the 2010, it's a date. It should recognize the each and every sentence over here. So that is what about the named entity recognition. So this should be also done in the sentiment analysis. And this is one type of example which has been taken at the time of the Trump campaign election. So at the time of his election, we just noted that he just tweeted from the two devices. First of all, from his iPhone device and later from the Android device. So we have seen that his tweets includes 628 tweets from iPhone and 762 tweets from Android. So this data has been taken in the R Studio, and after that it analyzed further. So after analyzing into further, we got this graph. Like in a day, he just tweeted like this. And the number of tweets and the with respect to the hours over here. So this is a totally technical which will be discussed in the R Studio. We should totally extract the data from the Twitter to the R. So next we will be seeing these words also. Mostly he has used badly, crazy, weak, spent, strong. These all the words he has used in the Android. And mostly he used the hashtag in the iPhone. You can also see over here. Like tomorrow 7 p.m. Trump in primary. So for example, these were the words he has used at the time of the campaign. And what are the most used terms in the campaign? Like he used the most of the word Hillary and the Trump 2016. So we can get all this information by doing the sentiment analysis in R. So next, how many tweets he has been tweeted by using the exclamation mark? In which device he has been tweeted? We can also know that by using the sentiment analysis. And how many number of tweets that he has been tweeted with pictures and without pictures. The data will be analyzed in the R. We can know by using the sentiment analysis over here. So this is the last chart that we got by doing analyzing the pattern, that whether the campaign is positive or negative, and how much sadness is there and how much fear is there among the people regarding the campaign and everything, and how much percentage it has been increased from Android to iPhone. This will be total, we can see in this chart. So this is all about sentiment analysis. And today I'm gonna brief summary of the sentiment analysis again. So first of all, we just seen what is sentiment analysis. Like what it is, sentiment means feeling. It has attitudes and emotions and opinions with respect to the user and everything. It means the subjective impressions, but not the facts of the product. It differ from person to person. And what is sentiment analysis, where we are going to use the sentiment analysis, and what we'll be getting by doing the sentiment analysis, like extracting the data and identifying the proper data. and studying the data and making it into subject information. And next, where we are going to apply the sentiment analysis. We are going to apply in the reviews that we have seen in the Amazon case and the survey responses. If you want to start any new business, we just have done the survey. So over here also sentiments applies, sentiment analysis apply, and also online and social media by segregating into the gender category and knowing the product, how it is going to succeed in the market before releasing the product and the healthcare materials. And what are the questions it is going to ask, whether the product is positive or negative and the customer is satisfied or dissatisfied. And by based on the sample number of tweets, is it necessary to run the campaign and everything. So what we got the information and the questions and the summarization by doing the sentiment analysis. So what are the challenges? I said, like we should know the proper content, whether it is not misleading. And we should know the substantial reversals. That is, we should identify the language and we should know whether it is positive or negative with respect to the user. And we should also identify the sarcasm and everything. So this is also, these are the three types of challenges that we'll be facing in the sentiment analysis. So how it is done? We have just classified according to users and text and sentences and words and tweets. And there are three types of techniques, as I said you, it is a semantic orientation and the text-based classification and the incorporating the shallow linguistics. So in over here, what we have done, we just kept a binary value for the each and every word. That is positive, zero or one. If it is positive, it is one. If it is negative, it's zero. So over here we have done the sentiment analysis in the semantic orientation and quality of words by using some of the specific formula. And in the text-based classification, we are just divided by topic and or segment or language or by genre, by author, whatever it may be. So these are the steps I said. First step is initialization step and the learning step and the evaluation step. And incorporating the shallow languages, linguistics. And over here, it offers two types of services like identification of the language and analyze the language. Over here, first, like, in the language identification, we are going to identify the language. And in the language analysis, we are going to split the sentences and we are going to do the tokenization and the lemmatization and the named entity recognition and classification. Like lemmatization, I said that whatever the terms which are relevant, like help, helps, and helping, this will be considered as only one term, help. And the tokenization, we will be giving some of the dummy value to each and every word so that the company will be having the privacy issues. It won't be disclosed to some other people. The named entity recognition. After getting the specific review, by doing the sentiment analysis, we should recognize whatever it may be. Like over here, the person name is Andrew. It's a person, you should recognize. And the date, 2010, it should recognize. Location. This will all be done by doing the sentiment analysis. And this is an example of Trump that we can do by do in RStudio by collecting all the data and by installing all the packages in that. So thank you for the webinar. This is all about the sentiment analysis and further will be continued by Mrunali ma'am.
So I'm requesting candidate, if you have any question, then you can ask at the end of the session. Now let's talk about analytics. So Defour is a basically IT consulting and solution company into analytics. We are providing business-driven analytics solutions with self-service, Celtrics, and R. So this is the Defour partner ecosystem. We are a technical partner with Altrics, training associate with Scholar University, and industry associate with MCCIE. So many of the students have a question in mind. Now data science is a very emerging career now. So I am belonging from such a type of background. So how it will be helpful to me?